It's that candy fresh, got the new now next. If you a dope artist in the city, come on and get your shine on, get your shine on. Candy fresh gon' show up, get your shine on. It's that candy fresh, got the new now next. If you a dope artist in the city, come on and get your shine on, get your shine on. Candy fresh gon' show up, get your shine on. It's that candy fresh, got the new now next. If you a dope artist in the city, come on and get your shine on, get your shine on. Candy fresh gon' show up, get your shine on. It's that candy fresh, got the new now next. If you a dope artist in the city, come on and get your shine on, get your shine on. Candy fresh gon' show up, get your shine on. And welcome to another episode of a girl power episode of yes. Candy Fresh. We are down in Minneapolis at A-Mail Artist Loft. It has been Candy Fresh approved. Y'all can see by the colors in the audience. My name is Sanni.
And I'm Miss Brit. What's up, Twin City? So we have a very special episode on tonight's show with a whole lot of special guests. Up first, we're going to have educator, activist, dancer, and choreographer, Miss Kenna Cottman. And then later on the show, we're going to have an interview and a live performance from Miss Timotha, Lanae.
Okay. We will also be interviewing my personal hair crush and social activist, Wintana, Melekin, as well as the owner and official cake lady, the owner and official cake lady of Xstravagant Events and Sweet Treats, Miss Tiffany Allen.
Yeah, she brought chicken and waffle cupcakes.
Enough to go around this time?
Well, I'm getting one. I'm getting one, but I also got to make sure I save a cupcake for our DJ tonight, and that's Brianne, who's going to be holding it down for us on the ones and twos, and of course for our Candy Fresh dancers, who are going to be moving around and keeping the energy live and hype, so make sure you make some noise for them.
Give it up for them. Give it up for the dancers, y'all. And also, we want to show some love to our celebrity guest host. She is an activist for autism, as well as a radio host for Go 96.3, Miss Shannon Paul. Give it up for her. She's here tonight. And last but not least, we want to make sure you give it up for yourselves, yes. Our Candy Fresh audience. Yes. Without y'all, we don't have this experience.
Yeah, so I think it's about time that we just go ahead and get started with the show. So make sure that you sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. This is
Candy Fresh.
Make some noise, y'all.
Good evening and welcome back to Candy Fresh. With me, I have a dancer, choreographer, CEO, educator, full Renaissance woman, Miss Kenna Cottman, with us here in the Candy Fresh studio. So welcome to Candy Fresh.
Thank you.
Excited to be here, excited to share and get to know everybody and have a great time.
Now, I saw you signing just a moment ago. How do you sign Candy Fresh?
Ooh.
Ooh, did I just put you on the spot? Okay, just kidding. We're going to edit that out. So welcome to Candy Fresh. We're excited to have you. So please tell us, what is it that you do and why?
Okay, I am a Black American griot. And a griot is like an oral historian, the bearer and creator of culture through the arts. And the reason why I do that is because I know what it feels to be raised in a welcoming, loving, pro-Black environment. And I want that for all of our children. So that's why I do what I do.
Excellent. And you do that through several different mediums, but one of them is through Voices of Culture. So tell us, what is VOC?
Voice of Culture. Yeah. Voice of Culture is more than just a drum and dance company. We do West African and Black American drumming and dancing, storytelling and singing, but we also create new rhythms and new ways and new modes of being Black. We're always opening up space and bringing it from the young to the old, so it's an intergenerational group. We do cultural education, we take field trips, we study things, we bring performances, you could say, but also it's like education to the community, like around our holidays and Black history, and we just try to educate along with create and be creative.
Excellent, excellent. Now, you were recently featured in, I believe it was the Star Tribune, for how you're educating young Black children on their history. For you, what does that look like in practice? Is it a specific curriculum that you've put together? Is it a day school? Is it after school? Especially for the parents out here, how do they get their kids involved in that environment?
Well, one thing I do is I teach full-time at the Best Academy, which is a charter school, Afrocentric school in Minneapolis. And the class I teach is Afrocentric Arts. So not only do we drum and dance, but we do creative projects. We just wrapped our Black History Performance Project, where we spent the month of February researching Black heroes and sheroes, as well as creating a timeline through the arts again. And we started in West Africa, we went through the history of hip hop through dance, and closed it out with the reenactment of the creation of the Black Lives Matter movement. So it's just like exploring our history and our culture through the arts, any way that we can. So I do that in my day job, I do that on the weekends with Voice of Culture, and I also work with another organization called We Win, which is a rites of passage and an after-school program. So those are all options that parents can use to get involved with what I do. And also, we're looking for more adults who are interested in the culture to be involved with Voice of Culture as well. It's not just for kids, it's trying to be intergenerational and get the wisdom that comes from all of the parts of our community to put into that pot.
Can we make some noise for Kenna right now? Invested in the future, but what is the future that you see for specifically the Black community here in Minneapolis, let's say within the next 10 years? What would you like to see?
Well, I'm really excited because a sister colleague of mine, Asale Sol Young, she's starting a new school in North Minneapolis. It's called Sankofa Underground North. And so I see us building our own schools and institutions that we create to give the cultural background that we know our children need to be successful. You know, we hear a lot about the achievement gap, and I'm like, I'm not even trying to compare us to nobody else. I'm just trying to get us to be fully embracing of our Blackness so that we can be successful and put back into our community. So the other thing that I'm excited about is there's a woman I work with, her name is Dudley Voigt, and she plans the Flow, which is the Northside Arts Crawl that happens every summer. So we're looking at ways to keep that going, as an annual thing, and then also bringing like some community theater and musicals to the Northside. So I'm seeing like a lot of artists, dancers, movers, actors in the house, and just be on the lookout for auditions for a community, family-based arts experience that we can all bring our families to and get involved in, and we hopefully that's going to be like an annual thing. So those are some things, like, because North Minneapolis is my heart, so just getting the North Side more vibrant with the arts and culture in our youth, that's what I see happening. Also, a revival of all of the energy that was created around the Fourth Precinct shutdown. My daughter, Yancey Jameson, she's an artist, activist, musician, and she was really instrumental in those protests, and I know that she has a lot of things planned with her young people. She works at NOC with Wintana and other people, so it's like we're all working on the North Side to try to bring our power and our agency to bear to make our community the way we want it to be.
Excellent. We can make some noise. People behind us who are getting ready to perform in a little bit. Can we have somebody come up and talk about?
I'm gonna ask Kevisar to come forward. I'm gonna introduce y'all to Kev. This is Kevisar Manier. She's one of the original. Yeah, let's see. And
She hates when I make her do stuff at the last minute, but she is an example of somebody who grew up in this culture. And not just from me, but from her own family and our community always surrounding her. But now she's such a shining example and a great leader. Like, she's definitely poised to take the leadership from me. So, Kenna, what do you want to say?
What do you have to say about your experience in Voice of Culture?
I just have to say that this whole experience, it's just brought me closer to my community, to my culture, to my history, and I'm really thankful for this whole experience and for also for you, Auntie. This has been really great. And yeah, it's just been a great educational, fun experience that's just kept me grounded, I guess. Yeah.
Excellent.
And you are getting ready to perform. So tell us, what are we getting ready to see?
We are getting ready to see two dances. One is called Fanga Alafia and the other is called Linjin. And we will also have a speaker talking about the founder of one of the dances. So.
Excellent, excellent. So really quick, before we wrap this up, tell us, where can people find out more about Voice of Culture and the other work that you do here in the community?
Voiceofculture.org is our website. You can find our calendar and my contact information. So if you or your children want to be involved, everybody's welcome. And also salon1016.org is a website from my family because my mother and father are also artists. So you can find out more about us there too.
Excellent. Well, we want to thank you guys so much for coming to Candy Fresh. We so look forward to this performance. Are y'all ready to perform?
Yeah.
Audience, are you ready to see this performance? Well, we're going to take a quick break and when we come back, we're going to get a live performance of Voice of Culture. But make sure you stay tuned because this is Candy Fresh.
It's that Candy Fresh, got the new now next. If you a dope artist in the city, come on and get your shine on, get your shine on. Candy Fresh.
now, a member of VLC will explain the dance we're doing next.
Hi, my name is Akili. I will be explaining about the next dance, La Fanga Alafia. As you can see, they are singing. And I will explain from Pearl Premise how she researched about where it came from. And so the Fanga part comes from Liberia, as you know, it's in Africa. And the Alafia part comes from Nigeria. And so she put that together, and so she made it like a beat together, and it just came famous and into this world and popular.
Some of our divas, our current divas right now.
These are our current divas. We actually take in 30 girls a year, and these are part of our cohort this year.
And when they are part of Project Diva, what do they do?
So they meet every Saturday starting in August. We align ourselves with the school year, and they get coaches in 6 different areas: academic, social, emotional, financial, health and wellness, and careers. And so the girls, they get the coaching, and it's really about the careers and aligning those soft skills around them as they learn how to advocate for themselves in school.
So it's one of those things where we're preparing them for the future, so it's not a big surprise when they go, here's what you have to deal with in the real world.
Exactly.
And I know that they do some little, we want to give them a chance to talk quickly. So do you guys have a preamble that you do? That's what we are? So who wants to start it off? So scoot on in here. Come on down here.
Wherever I'm,
we're making
progress. I am a diva.
Yeah. So training. So if people want to learn more about Project Diva, how do they find you?
You can find us at projectdiva.org.
Nice. Divas, give me a high five. Come on, Divas. All right, ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Project Diva.
It's that candy fresh, got the new now next. If you a dope artist in the city, come on and get your shine on, get your shine on. Candy fresh, gonna shine.
We have Miss Wintana Melekin here with us today. And she is not only a social activist, she is my head crush. Believe me, it's going to be installed.
Yeah,
so, first tell us a little bit about yourself. Was that better?
Yeah. Hi, my name is Wintana Melekin. I work at NOC, Minnesota Neighborhoods Organizing for Change. Also, I saw Miss Shannon. That's my former boss and also a mentor, an amazing human being. But I work at NOC and I work on community organizing. So I work on everything from public policy to disruption. So the whole spectrum.
All right, okay. So. Here's a big question. I do a fresh question and I do a sweet question. So this is the fresh question. All right, so the other day I was doing my little searching, trying to figure you out. And you reposted something on Facebook that was showing Cardi B from Love & Hip Hop some love. And my first thought was, she's an activist. She just don't seem like she would like somebody like Cardi B. You know, a lot of people talk about her past as a dancer. And so my question to you is, being a social activist, do you think that there's anything that can be done the way we see women who might not have had a good past, but are moving towards a better future?
Yeah, definitely. I'm a huge fan of Cardi B. I love me some more than hip-hop.
I do too.
For real. But specifically, that post was about respectability politics. Too many times we police women, particularly black women, about their past, but we don't invest in their futures. So if Cardi B is talking about why another character should be respecting other women, that should have no effect on what her reputation is or what she's done in the past. We should respect all black women, including Cardi B, which is why I'm a fan of her, because she fights for a voice that's often unheard.
So she's a social activist in the home group?
Definitely, definitely.
All right, so here's the sweet question. What changes have you made in your career that made you believe in the power of organizing?
Definitely. So I worked for a healthcare company for 10 years off and on, from when I was 15 till I was 25. And I actually quit this around this time 4 years ago. So there's a Facebook event for the Trayvon Martin rally that had happened 4 years ago at the U of M. And I went to that rally, and that's how I heard about NOC. And I actually quit my job, quit everything I was doing, and started working at NOC. When I started there, we had a $15,000 budget. There was my boss, and I was part-time staff, only working 15 hours a week. Now we are an organization with almost 20 full-time staff, a full budget, our own office, our own space, and we regularly are winning policy. Also, we're a 99% black staff organization, and so it was worth it. That's why I did it. So I always like to give our guests opportunity to talk about any events that are coming up in the near future. So what's going on with you, Ms. Social Activist? Definitely. Well, many of you know that the case for Jamar Clark is happening right now. Jamar Clark was killed by the Minneapolis Police Department. He was executed. Many say that he was handcuffed. And there's an ongoing case. We recently got an announcement that there will be no grand juries. Most grand juries in Minnesota don't work, actually nationally. Minnesota, second to California, is the only county in America that has banned grand juries, which is huge. For the police to prosecute the officers that shot Jamar, and so we should be hearing results within the next week. So I just say keep in tune with our Facebook and our Twitter and stay active. And also just to reiterate that, like, this grand jury win was huge. It's national. Most other people had to unelect their county commissioners, their mayors, their city councils. We didn't have to do that. They got so scared they listened. So what does it look like to continue to scare them and kick them out and run some of you for office? And that's what I'm interested in. So if you want to get plugged into NOC, feel free to come up to me. Go to our Twitter and our Facebook, follow me on Twitter or Facebook, and just get plugged in and realize, like, the revolution is now. Like, you're not waiting for the second one. It's right now at this moment. So get engaged.
Give it up. So I see the riveting for making Miss Wintana not stay and talk about some social change. The queen straight stepped out.
So where can we find you? You can find me.
Because you everywhere.
Yeah, I am everywhere. You can find me on Twitter at WintanaMN, or you can just follow NOC, which is at MNNOC, on Twitter, Facebook. I think we have a Snapchat now, so all the social media networks.
Well, thank you for coming out with us, Wintana.
Thank you for inviting me.
You watch a Candy Crush. Be right back.
Thank you. Monday, some come on Tuesday, some come both days. Mm-hmm. And it's just a drop-in class, so people can come at any time when they feel like it.
Nice. Okay, so for new potential students and people that want to participate, how do they find you?
And you can find me on Facebook under Gotta Dance, Line Dance, or Tina Lady of Line Dance Jackson. Look me up. We have people, like I said, we have men, women, children, seniors, just a bunch of fun folks. Mm-hmm.
Well, I am going to work on my stamina, and then come on and join you one more time. Give it up for our line dance.
It's that candy fresh, got the new now next. If you a dope artist in the city, come on and get your shine on, get your shine on. Candy fresh.
Extravagant events and sweet treats. Welcome to Candy Fresh.
Thank you for having me.
They clapping already. Everybody in there know about chicken and waffles.
So we're going to start out simple. Tell us about extravagant events and sweet treats. A little bit about yourself, how that started. Were you the cake lady when you was little?
No, actually I was not. I actually did not bake when I was little.
Well, how are you getting to all that sweet stuff?
Well, extravagant events and sweet treats start off as primarily an event planning company. And then eventually, I just, one year, decided to bake my daughter's cake, and it just kind of started from there about 3 years ago.
So everybody was eating their cake?
Yeah, basically.
And then they was like, why don't you go into business?
Yeah, you know what, to believe it or not, I did not have the confidence at first to even start doing cakes. People used to come to me like, well, can you do this cake? Can you do that cake? I'm like, I don't know. So, but I watched a lot of YouTube and just my skills.
Step up to the cake challenge?
No, actually. I started to really enjoy it. Once I built my confidence level up, I really started to do it. And one day I decided, you know what, I'm just step outside the box and decide to open up a cupcake shop. And that's what I decided to do. And yeah.
How many years ago was it?
Well, I opened my shop last year. And I did currently close it, so I'm looking for a new location. But I started doing cakes about 3.5 years ago.
Well, I'm glad, because chicken and waffles.
All right, so I have a fresh question and I have a sweet question for you. So the fresh question is, tell us about this Food Network situation going on.
Y'all heard about this lady gonna be on Food Network? Tell us.
All right, well, I did, I went and auditioned for Cake Wars. So can't talk about it too much, but it does come on Monday at 8 o'clock.
Give it up.
Searching like to find out about my guests, and somebody's like, y'all need to give it up, she came to slay. So make sure y'all like her page. What's the name of your Facebook page?
Xstravagant Events and Sweet Treats.
So make sure y'all go out and like that. So here's your sweet question. What's your most popular sweet treat?
Well, my most popular sweet treat would be the chicken and waffle cup.
I told y'all! Chicken and waffles!
Well, so when I say popular, I mean, is that the one that people are always asking you to make? Do you have this in cake form?
I can make it in a cake form, but the most popular version is a cupcake.
Can you do that for Candy Fresh? Is that okay?
We need a cake.
Okay, we need a cake. Okay, we're going. All right, so with every guest, I like to ask them about any events they got going on. I specifically would like to know about this. It's dinner and dessert?
Well, I started working with the chef, Chef Rob, and last month we decided to do a dinner and dessert. So every month we'll come out with a 5-course meal, full bar, and it's basically we sell 25 tickets, and it's real intimate, and it's one of those things we try to do something different for the city. So
okay, all right. Any more events other than I want to know more about that backstage for me and the boo. But any other events other than that you want to talk about?
Right now I'm working on a few different things. I'm going to be bringing back my cupcake and my cake decorating workshops, but those are primarily for kids. I love working with the kids, so. Those will be coming back shortly, and then look out for me. I'm going to be opening up another shop soon. So.
So last question, where can we find you?
You can find me on Facebook. I'm always on Facebook under either Tiffany Allen or Xstravagant Events and Sweet Treats. I'm also on Instagram under XE_sweets. Which is also linked to my Twitter, which is Xstravagant Events.
Got people drooling on social media. Well, thank you for joining us on Candy Fresh. This is definitely the spot you need to be. And hopefully you'll come back again. And good luck with your show on Food Network.
Thank you very much, and thank you for having me.
Y'all give it up to Tiffany. Watch your Candy Fresh.
It's that Candy Fresh, got the new now next. If you a dope artist in the city, come on and get your shine on, get your shine on. Candy for...
Welcome back to Candy Fresh. My name is Miss Britt, and next to me I have a singer, a songwriter, an actress, an entrepreneur. Her album Red went number one on the UK soul charts, and now she's back in the United States with us. Please continue to make some noise for Miss Timotha, Lanae. Welcome. How are you?
I'm doing wonderful. Thanks for having me.
It's so wonderful to have you here. I feel like I'm just like next to a celebrity. It's so cool. So why don't we just go ahead and get into it? So for those of our people in the audience or at home who aren't familiar with your work, tell us about what you do.
Well, like you said, I'm a singer, songwriter. Just love all things entertainment, all things creative. That's why I love being here on Candy Fresh. Yeah. Yeah. But you know, I love to create. I love to songwrite and just express myself through music, and that's what a lot of what I do. I also do a lot of theater. I was just in Sister Act out at Chanhassen Dinner Theaters. That just closed, and I just like to do anything creative, all things entertainment, all things creative.
Super dope. And so you are not only beauty and talent, but brains as well. So I actually read that you received a scholarship to the University of Minnesota, and you decided it was an education, so you're actually going to be a teacher, is that correct? Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I actually went to the U of M to be a teacher. My degree is in education, and I decided, you know, I love working with youth, but my first passion is music, so I decided to just follow my dream of music and then find a way to put education and youth into that. So I do different things in the schools. I have a thing called the BU Project, where I go into schools, do workshops, things like that. So I'm doing both of my loves, but I decided to follow my first passion, which is music. I've been doing it since I was little. I just had to follow that dream and that passion.
I love that. I love that. We can make some noise for that. Now, I have to ask, how did you have the courage to decide, you know, that there's one path in front of you, and it may have seemed like, for some people, an obvious choice and a safe choice, mm-hmm. but you decided, like, no, I'm going to find a way to do both and to pursue my dreams. Yeah. What was that breaking point for you, or that final motivator to say, I'm going to do this?
That's a great question. You know, I'm thinking back, reflecting, and, you know, I feel like God placed a lot of amazing people in my life, one of them being my husband, who I met while I was in college. And he just told me, he was like, you know, you love music. You should just try to follow your dream and see what happens. And if it doesn't work out, you have this degree to fall back on, but at least see what happens. And he really encouraged me. And so I just have to say, it was my husband first and foremost, but God first and foremost, who placed him in my life and then gave me encouragement and just that wake up call. Just follow my dream. And that, I've been doing it ever since, and I'm so thankful.
Make some noise for that.
Good husbands, blessings, talents, being able to listen and be obedient. I love that. I love that.
So tell me, where has he led you since you decided to pursue this full time?
Well, you know, you talked about my album Red, and that album actually went number one on the UK Soul chart. So excited about that. Release, so we released it over in the UK. I worked with an amazing producer here in town. His name is Ben Obi, Savannah Street Music. So we worked on that album and also my second EP, Rewind, which also went to number one in the UK. It went to number one on the Sweet Rhythms chart. So it's just, God's been really blessing me. And I'm working on some new music now where I'm getting more involved with production, working with new different people. And I've been working with Ryan Lissman, who's an amazing singer and songwriter, and he was a part of Jonas Brothers Band for about 7 years. And also we wrote this new single, Open Road, with Michael Bland, who is an amazing drummer here in town. Some of you all might remember him. He was the drummer for Prince, New Power Generation. He also drums with Soul Asylum. So just working with new people, collaborating and making new music. And this new single, Open Road, actually entered the UK Soul chart at number 28 and moved up to number 25 this week. So,
with all our Candy Fresh listeners and watchers at home, make sure you request that at your radio stations, purchase the single, all that good stuff, so we can get that up on the charts. So tell us about this performance we're going to see tonight, because you actually get to see a little sample, a little Candy Fresh snippet tonight. So tell us, what are we going to see?
So tonight I'm going to do a song from my EP Rewind, and it's called God, Love, Music. And those are the three things that I need, okay? So this song is a song that I wrote just kind of like my anthem, you know? So it's like, if you want to be in my world, it's specifically for a guy, even though I am married, but you know, hypothetically, you know what I'm saying?
I mean, you got to keep him guessing too. You got to work, hubby. You got to keep him working.
Exactly, but it's just saying the things that make me tick are God, love, and music, and I need those things. And so it's really, the song came from a conversation I had with my mother. It's kind of like those different advice moments, you know, where you really feel like I'm getting nuggets of wisdom here. And my mom was just telling me at one point, she was like, you know, Timotha, your time is expensive. And then I was like, ooh. That's true. You know, you can't get it back. It's priceless. It's expensive. And so there's a line in the song that talks about, you know, nothing's more expensive than your time. So don't waste it. So you got to know what you need, what you want. You know, so that's kind of what the song God Love Music from my EP Rewind.
Love it. Thanks so much for that. Love it. So we're obviously getting ready to see
connect with you, all that good stuff? Okay, well, you can find me online everywhere. My website, TimothaLanae.com, and it's Timotha, like Timothy, but with an A. I'm named after my dad. Shout out to him. So TimothaLanae.com, and then I'm on everything, Twitter, Instagram, Periscope, all of those things, you know, Facebook, so just Timotha Lanae. Yeah.
We want to thank you so much for coming. We look forward to your performance in just a moment. And for all of you watching at home, remember that your time is expensive. And speaking of that, we're going to go ahead and take a quick little break. So don't go anywhere, because this is Candy Fresh.
Big fan of a statement piece of jewelry, so I'm very excited to talk to our next Candy Fresh audience, VIP. This is Leah Bartisol, and she is the designer and creator behind
Consume to Survive.
There we go. Now, what is the inspiration for Consume to Survive?
Well, I have my background in hip-hop activism as a lyricist. In my 20s, I was inspired by a lot of political motivations. A lot of my pieces really mean something a lot deeper than most pieces of jewelry you would ever find. I like to use propaganda, but kind of portray it in a more of a sort of a feminine, sexy way, I guess you would say. I incorporate my pinup girl photography into my jewelry line. So you'll find images of fierce women holding a gun. And I call those women the one that got away, because that's the category under how I label myself as a single, strong, surviving female on this planet.
And we have a few pieces here, so let's go over a few of the pieces we brought with us this evening.
Sure, these are some of my pieces. This one is the one that got away, little pinup girl photo shoot we did. I have a lot of Minnesota pride, so we represent the lady slipper, which is also endangered, and so I like to bring awareness to that. The Che Guevara earrings down here are pretty great, because he was an amazing leader that did incredible things for the country of Cuba as far as literacy rates and benefits to those experiencing poverty and injustice. I have the little fist of power here to represent the struggle and the movement and what we represent coming together to make greater change.
So what do you say to people that are go, you know what, this jewelry looks very aggressive. What is your response to that?
Well, I hope they do say that, because I would like to evoke some sort of reaction from people. Even the jewelry itself seems understated until the light hits it. And once the light hits it, your eye is caught. And then I hope people do say, what does that mean? So you can begin a conversation.
And if we want to join the conversation to get some of this amazing jewelry, where do we find you?
You can find me at consumetosurvive.com. I'm also on Facebook and Instagram, and I have a lot of fun taking photos and posting live footage and just kind of showing the process of creativity and interacting with my community.
Well, I am going to be wearing a numerous ones of these jewelry so that I can show that I am not passive aggressive at all. I am completely aggressive. I agree with you. Yes. So thank you very much for sharing.
Thank you. Have a great day.
I do. I like that. I like me right here. I'm feeling that.
Sugar coat. I gotta make
Kenna, Cottman, and the young people with Voice of Culture. Much love to them, as well as to the awesome performance from Timotha, Lanae.
Yeah, give it up. Also want to show some love to Wintana, Melekin, my hair crush, Wintana, I got you. And also Miss Tiffany Allen with the chicken and waffle cupcakes.
What we doing? That's how I know God is good. Because there's a batch of cupcakes waiting for me as soon as we wrap this up.
Yes.
That's how I know. But we also want to send a special thank you to And That's Breon, who's been our DJ this evening. And of course, a very special thank you to all of the dancers who participated in tonight's episode. Y'all were amazing. And we just about to get my nail a pump.
And of course, last but not least, we want to give a big, huge shout out to our Candy Fresh audience. Without you guys, we would not be able to have this experience. So give it up
for
yourselves. Also, we got to give a big shout out to the young ladies of Project Diva for coming out and hanging out with us. Give some love, y'all.
Give
some
love, y'all. Our t-shirts as
well.
T-shirts,
we matching.
And of course, a big thank you to the Crown Lens team who always holds it down, especially to Aaron, who just had a birthday.
Happy birthday! Come on, Aaron. Come on, they can't see you. Come on, Aaron. Crown Lens, baby. Yeah. Follow us on Twitter, Instagram, like our Facebook, and subscribe to our channel on YouTube, Crown Lens Media Group. Brittany, take us home.
All right, y'all. That's all the time we have on tonight's episode. Thank you for rocking with us. We'll be back next time for National Poetry Month. And as always, make sure you keep it
candy fresh.
It's that candy fresh. Got the new now next. If you a dope artist in the city, come on and get your shine on. Get your shine on. Candy fresh gon' show up. Get your shine on. It's that candy fresh. Got that new now next. If you a dope artist in the city.